Hello, hello. So I found a cool thing you can do with the laser designator. Laser designator. That is, this is when you designate a target, and this is when you laser it, this little circle. I found out that if you can toggle between view, and if you don't disable a laser. Except didn't do it that time. You can actually continue designating targets beyond their gimbal limits of your camera. I'll show you. When you go back to cockpit view, they're still designated. The angle limit of the gimbal limit of the camera is usually quite limited, so for the show, this is with the sight stabilized. You can see there's a little crosshair. If I turn too much, it will disappear. As you can see, I can't see anymore. So what you want to do is basically go to the camera view, disable sight stabilization. And well, have your laser designator on first. Disable sight stabilization and quickly switch to cockpit view as quick as possible. So the bindings I have is toggle view, go back to cockpit view, it doesn't matter. I've got right shift and backslash, and disable sight stabilization to the same key. Granted, there's a bit of a delay because I use a two-button binding. One works on release, another one works on press. So you need to take that into consideration. So you need to press the key as quick as possible. Now, to show you a example, I don't remember what the ground units were. Okay, there's one. The missile on the way. And I quickly press a key and now I can turn away. I still need to remain line of sight, otherwise the missile will just self-destruct. As you can see, the missile is still guiding, even though I'm well outside the gimbal limit, and I've destroyed the target. Good thing about this as well is you can also use it to you can use it to mark a target that you didn't have time to use your weapon, your guided weapon on. Come with dumb bombs as low as possible. But one of the big hinders is that, you know that bug just now I showed you just now where the camera was pointing the wrong direction? That unfortunately you can't really solve. You just have to go back to the view again. So I'll try. Anyway, I'll give you a demo of the ADATs. Where's ADATs? I know it's somewhere around here. So let's say you shot a missile on ADATs, but your missile was too slow and you didn't get the missile to turn in time, but you still have the target designated. Whoa! Can't believe I made that out alive. But anyway, you can see I have the target marked. It's not the most accurate. But now it means I can come in low with bombs. Granted that I didn't actually designate the target that accurately because the whole ground collision problem. Let's see, you can come in very low, out of sight, and you can drop the bombs of CCIP onto it. Like that. Pretty neat. But yeah, that's all I really wanted to show you in this video. Has some serious abuse potential. Make your CAS aircraft way more competent. This exploit will probably mostly affect mouse aim modes more than sim, but it is a very useful thing to have in sim because Guardian can't fucking code HUDs properly in the game for whatever fucking reason. But yeah, it should make your plane a bit more, well, playable. I don't know where that third missile went.
Over. G.
Have a nice day.